Welcome to Evolve Science X. What is matrix science? Have you ever wondered if the world around you is really real? Or if everything you see, hear, and feel is just an illusion? What if the universe you live in is just a simulation, an artificial reality, a matrix that your mind has been programmed to experience? Well, today, we're diving into a mind-bending concept. Matrix science. What it is, how it connects to our minds, and whether the reality we experience is the same for everyone, or if some of us are living in different levels of this matrix. Stick around as we uncover whether this theory is absurd or possibly true. When we talk about the matrix, our first instinct might be to think of the 1999 sci-fi movie where humans are trapped in a computer-generated simulation. But the concept of the matrix goes beyond Hollywood and touches on mathematics, biology, and even quantum physics. In the simplest sense, a matrix is an organized structure of elements or numbers. In mathematics, a matrix is an array of numbers, which scientists use to solve equations, transform shapes, and model systems. It's a tool that shapes our understanding of everything from engineering to economics. But in biology, a matrix has a different meaning. Think of it as a supportive framework, like the extracellular matrix, a structure that supports the cells in your body. Without it, your cells wouldn't function properly. So, what does this all have to do with the mind? What if we told you that reality itself, your perception of the world, could be another kind of matrix? A projection of your brain's interpretation of information. That's where things start to get interesting. Our minds shape the way we experience reality. Think about it. The brain takes in billions of data points from our senses every second, but it doesn't present all that information to us in raw form. Instead, it filters and processes it, building a mental model that we call reality. What we perceive is, in essence, a construct. It's not necessarily what's out there, but rather what our brains interpret from the external world. This is where the idea of the matrix starts to look less like science fiction and more like a scientific possibility. In simulation theory, proposed by philosopher Nick Bostrom, the concept is simple. What if we're all living in a computer-generated simulation? The idea suggests that our minds could be tricked into thinking this world is real, when in fact, it's an elaborate simulation. Our minds, like the processors in a computer, receive input from the outside world and create our reality based on that information. We see colors, shapes, and movements, but in reality, all of this might just be data interpreted by our minds, like pixels on a screen. It's a bit like the Matrix movie, where humans are trapped in a simulated world, unaware of their true existence. Could our brains be generating our perception of reality the same way a computer would simulate a world for us? Let's dive deeper. Is it the same for everyone? Or do some people live in different matrix levels? Now here's where it gets even more fascinating. If reality is, in fact, a mental construct, then could it be the same for everyone? Or do some people experience different levels of this matrix? In psychological terms, we all have unique mental frameworks. These frameworks are built from our personal experiences, culture, education, and even genetics. So, while two people might look at the same object, the way they experience it can be very different. One person might see a simple red apple, while the other might associate it with childhood memories or even cultural meanings. This idea suggests that each of us could be living in a different level of the matrix, our own subjective version of reality. This is something that's been explored in spiritual traditions as well. In Buddhism, for example, awakening is the process of realizing that the reality we experience is not as concrete as we think. In this sense, some people might be able to wake up from their matrix and see the world differently. It's as if they've broken free of the constructed reality, moving to a higher level of understanding. This raises a deeper question. If the matrix is shaped by our minds, can we actually change our perception of reality, sort of like changing levels in a video game? Is it reality or just an absurd theory? So, is this whole matrix theory just absurd, or could there be something to it? Let's turn to some thinkers and scientists who have brought this idea into the mainstream. Philosopher René Descartes famously said, "I think, therefore, I am." But he also suggested that the world we see might not be real. Maybe we're just dreaming, or worse, being deceived by an evil demon. Fast forward to today, and simulation theorists like Nick Bostrom argue that the chances we're living in a simulation are actually pretty high. The red pill moment, awakening to new matrix levels. This brings us to the idea of the red pill moment. In the matrix, Neo takes the red pill and wakes up to the real world. Could there be a similar red pill in our own lives? Moments that allow us to break through our mental matrix and perceive reality differently? What if certain life experiences, like a deep personal crisis, a spiritual awakening, or even a scientific revelation, could serve as our red pill, awakening us to new levels of awareness? It's possible that some people have higher levels of awareness about reality than others. They've seen beyond the veil, so to speak, and they understand that reality is not as fixed as it seems. This could explain why some people seem to be living in a different matrix. They've transcended the limitations of their initial perception. Conclusion: is this just science fiction? So, is the matrix theory just a science fiction fantasy? Or could it be an actual explanation for the nature of reality? While we don't have all the answers, one thing is clear. The concept challenges us to think deeply about our perceptions, our minds, and the very nature of existence. Whether we're living in a matrix or not, what we know for sure is that reality is much more mysterious than we tend to think. And as science continues to evolve, so too will our understanding of what reality truly is. So, next time you look at the world around you, ask yourself, is it really as real as you think? Or is there a deeper, more complex matrix at play? The answer, perhaps, is something only your mind can discover. Until next time, keep evolving and keep questioning. If you enjoyed this deep dive into matrix science, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to Evolve Science X, and let us know in the comments. Do you think we're living in a matrix? Or is this all just an absurd theory? See you next time.